Hi guys, thanks for joining us at the Painter's Loft. We're live here. We're going to be doing some paper mache eggs today. While everyone is hunkering down and staying home from being sick from everything that's happening, we hope you can join us and have some fun creative activities that we can do at home, just with simple things that you have around the house. We also want to let you know that we have projects here that you can take home as well. So we do have a 2 for $20 ceramic kit that you can pick up in store and bring home and paint. And we also have other art kits and projects that you can work on from home. So actually next Friday, we will also be offering a paint project. So we would be offering the canvas and paints, and we would have a stencil for the canvas, and you can pick up this project. You can use any supplies that you have at home. There is a deposit for some of the art supplies. So if you want to join us next Friday at 2 p.m., you can do a live artist painting with us for the sloth. So for today's at-home paper mache, we're gonna do things that you basically have lying around. So we have Elmer's glue, we have some cut pieces of newspaper, some tissue paper to add some color. We have some ribbon that we can decorate our eggs. So let's get started. So if you have balloons that you can use to make your shape for your egg, anything that you have, any sizes. I have little balloons that I use that I found some water balloons around my house. And we also have bigger balloons that you can do, so you can do different kinds of eggs today. So I'm gonna get started with our mixture. So our mixture here is 1 to 1 Elmer's glue and water. You can also add a little bit of flour or cornstarch. If you are gonna mix any of that in there, you wanna make sure that you use warm water. So you wanna make sure it's like a light milky consistency, so that you can create a nice paste to create your egg. So to get started, I already have some strips cut up of newspaper. They don't have to be perfect. You can just do random strips. You can even tear up some pieces. They don't have to be perfectly cut. And we're gonna start dipping our strips into the paper. And you don't want it to be completely drenched. You can just use your fingers and take off some of the moisture and start layering it on top of your balloon. You're just going to keep doing this with a couple layers of paper. Take out some more drips. So the balloons are a great way to hold its shape once your paper mache dries. You'll have this nice round egg-looking sphere that you can work with, which is good because you can do different sizes. If you do different size balloons, you can have different size eggs. You want to overlap your strips a little bit just so everything sticks to each other. a great project that you can do at home with kids and get ready for Easter. Especially with things that you just have around the house that you don't have to go out to the store and get. So right now I'm just going to keep layering on the strips of the newspaper as it's drying. I'll show you some examples of some other smaller balloons I was working on earlier. You can also use a cup if it doesn't want to stay still. Standing. So I used one of these smaller balloons earlier while that bigger one is drying. We can work on decorating one of the smaller ones. This has a layer of newspaper already on it, and we can use tissue paper to layer on our egg. So you don't need a lot of mixture with the tissue paper, it's very thin, but just enough so that it'll start to stick to the newspaper. You can use different colors. And if you don't want to get super messy, you can actually use this to paint on with some of this solution. Different techniques, different patterns. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but it'll be eventually a nice colorful shape. You can even cut out some cool little Easter egg patterns that you can put on top of your egg. Some brushing, just a little bit on because you don't need a lot with the tissue paper. What's really cool about using the tissue paper is that it's really translucent, so you can do different colors and layer it over. And the yellow and pink here, you have like a little bit of orange, that's kind of cool. Tissue paper just to cover up some of the newspaper. You can do a fun stripe pattern. You can also use different things if you wanted to do some circles. You can cut out some circles and put them on your Easter egg as like a fun design. Use the brush for this one.
have to be perfect. It's just going to be a fun little colorful Easter egg. So you want to do a couple layers of paper just to make sure that it's a little bit sturdier. Adding the starch or some flour to your mixture is definitely going to make it a little bit thicker. So that's going to help everything, keep everything sturdy. So there's other fun things that you can add to this as well. So you can do more of like a paper texture pattern with using like crosswords, like the cool diagonal lines. So you can cut out some of those strips. What's fun about this is that you can use any colored paper. You can use just scrap piece of paper. You can use different tissue paper, anything, and use it with the paste, and it will stick with the egg. So I'm gonna flip my egg around and do color on this side. I'm gonna do this cool crossword pattern on this side. Just to show different options of what you can do. I don't want that much. Checkered pattern. So you can make them all out of newspaper, you can make them all out of one single color if you'd like. You can even cut shapes out of paper and paste them on that way, so you can put different designs on the eggs. A little checkerboard pattern here. That's one side, my colorful side. So I'm gonna let this one dry a little bit. I'm gonna use like a little cup here again. Kind of let that sit for a little bit. So if you have little things that are around the house that you think that you would like to add, you could add things like attach some ribbon to your egg once you're finished to kind of give it some finishing touches. You can paint on top of your dried paper once it's done. You can create little patterns. I have some paint over here. Add to it. You can do any acrylic paint that would dry, or watercolor might not show up as well. This would be kind of cute to do those pattern. So if you wanted to use any ribbon, you can use glue on the back of your ribbon and then just glue it right onto your piece. earlier. It's got little patches of orange and yellow and pink. Just a cute little ribbon to go around. And if you have anything else that you wanted to add, you can continuously build up layers with these if you wanted to add some designs to it. So I have this little cutout piece of paper here. I think that would look really cute if we had that. So instead of dipping the whole sheet of paper in, you can just use the paintbrush and put a little bit of glue on your egg and just paint the paste to the top layer here. This way you have this cute little dried fringe towards the bottom as well. You can do multiple balloons at a time since these dry a little bit at a time, so you can add different layers. To fully dry, you want to let this sit overnight. Once you add probably about 2 to 3 layers of paper to make sure it's completely hard enough before you cut the balloon, just so everything keeps its shape. Abstract little colors here. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's going to end up being really cute and colorful at the end. So there's other things that you can add. If you don't actually have balloons, there's a cute thing that we can do to show you. So not everybody has balloons hanging around in their house. So I'm going to set aside. You can make little tiny crumpled up pieces of paper and tape them. We can make little eggs just out of the newspaper itself and some tape. Once you make like a little egg shape here, you can take up.
shape form. We have a little egg crate here. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're gonna go over it with some more of the paper mache mixture. So I have two little paper eggs here that fit nicely in my little egg crate. These are fun little things you can do if you don't have balloons. So to make sure this is secure, I'm just gonna add some more strips of newspaper to go around. Going to be a little bit loose at first, but once it dries just a little bit, we can add another layer of paper. We can even add some tissue paper around. Colorful. So tissue paper actually is really thin, and if you get it too wet, it'll crumple and fold on itself, but that's okay because it adds a little bit of texture. Comes out with a cool pattern. I'm gonna make this one really colorful. Adding more layers as you go, and this guy will fit really cute in your little egg crate here. This one's not working. This one. add some more tissue paper to give it kind of like more form, the shape of everything. Good reason to kind of work on multiple ones at the same time, so you can let them dry a little bit as you can work on another one. Let's go back to this one. This one's a little bit more dry. Have to do probably like the top part where you can paint on some of the glue. Add like another layer to go around. So I'm gonna just fold this in half, so it's an extra long piece of pattern. I'm just going to create these little half circle scalloped edges. I still have some glue left over on top of here, so I'm just going to layer on top of this one. Because the tissue paper is so thin, it still stays. And then you can just brush on some more of the mixture to the top so it stays put. So you don't have to do the same exact pattern. You can do zigzags, you can do half circles, you can even cut out full circles if you want to go around your egg and do different patterns. I'm just going to keep layering so you get this little scalloped pattern. Add some more of my mixture. And then I'm just going to add a couple more layers down towards the bottom. So you can even do these as like half eggs if you want when you're done. When you are done and everything is dried, you can cut out the top half and just keep them as like half shell Easter eggs. Fill them up with fun goodies. If your tissue paper is a little bit transparent, it's okay. You can just go over it with another layer if you'd like. I'm going to add more of the paste. Make sure this layer stays on. Thank you.
dry a little bit, you can go back. See the little Easter eggs? So I think for the little Easter eggs, we can do some fun strips, make them really colorful. Comics here would be kind of cool. You can do fun zigzags with the comics. The egg's still a little bit wet, so it's sticking a little bit already. You can alternate between color and then the comics. Make a cool design. Sticking that well, just add a little bit more of your mixture.
you're done with your egg, you can let it completely dry. You're going to cut a little stem here of the balloon, and you can pull the balloon out. If you're making it a full egg, you can do paper mache all the way to the top. I have a bigger hole here at the top, so you can always fill it with candy or little goodies, and then you can always just put a piece of paper mache on top and add a couple of other layers of paper if you'd like, just to have like fun little Easter egg ornaments. So there's different ideas that you can do. I hope this helps keep everybody entertained and giving some fun activities and ideas that you can do with paper mache and Easter decorations while you're home today. Visit thepaintersloft.com, and if you guys decide to join in and do this project, please post your pictures and hope everything works out. Thanks.